Hi, my name is Javier, and I want to introduce to you a new repository, the QuestDB Quickstart. So you can use this repository when you want to showcase or to play with an end-to-end demo of QuestDB. As you know, QuestDB is an open source 10 series database. So it's a bit tricky sometimes to build an end-to-end workflow because you need to have a working instance of QuestDB, you need to create tables, you need to ingest data, you need to do something with the data. So this quick start helps you with all of that. What it's going to do, we're going to be using QuestDB to ingest both batch and streaming data in real time. And we are going to have a third-party tool, Grafana, to build dashboards, real-time dashboards, that refresh every few seconds with data ingesting in real-time into QuestDB. The first thing is the repository lives under the rest of repositories for QuestDB. So this is the QuestDB Quickstart on GitHub, and I'm going to just clone the repository to my machine. Git clone. In this repository, as I told you, we're going to do several things. We're going to need the QuestDB database, we are going to need some script to ingest streaming data, and we are going to need Grafana, a third-party tool for representing charts and dashboards. You can install this in different ways. I'm going to give you three options. You choose the one which is best for you. As a developer, I find it very convenient to start everything using just Docker and Docker Compose. So I'm going to start with that one. For Docker Compose, all I need is just Docker Compose app, and this will pull all the dependencies. It will download the QuestDB image. It will download the Grafana image. It will build an image based on Python for the streaming data, the streaming sample data. And after it finishes, it will automatically have data ingested into QuestDB. So I can see already the logs. I can see data is already being ingested into QuestDB. You can see here we have some writer logs. So that means my installation is up and ready. And let me check that out. Right now, I should have a web interface here, the Grafana web interface, with a user demo and a password quest. And if I click here, sure enough, demo quest. I log in and I can see some data into QuestDB. Actually some data in this chart. This data is refreshing automatically every 5 seconds. I can see I've already ingested over 8,000 records. And if I click on any of these charts here, I can see these are just SQL that I could change and play with it and learn a bit more about QuestDB. So that's a very good way, a very simple way of just getting started. There is another way, which is also very simple. And this is if you don't want to install anything locally. If you want to have like a fully managed experience deploying the quick start, you can use Gitpod. Gitpod is a hosted service, a third-party tool, in which you can have a development environment. And as a free user, you can get a few hours for free every month. So if you have Gitpod, you can click just here and open. If not, you need to create an account. So I'm going to just create a new account on Gitpod. I'm going with the defaults. I need to pass this, this thing here, the survey. And just like that, what this is going to do is going to start my quick start on an environment in Gitpod. So it will take a little bit, but eventually it's going to do exactly the same thing we just did locally. It's going to download the images from Docker. It's going to build the image for streaming data. And eventually it will open a window with the URL for the Grafana dashboard that we already saw. So I'm just going to wait a few seconds. So I can see now that data is flowing in the logs. And actually, I saw here the browser tried to open a pop-up. So I can see here, it actually tried to open two different URLs, one for Grafana, one for QuestDB. So this is the one for Grafana, demo quest. And I can see the same dashboard I just saw you using Docker Compose, just working in a fully hosted environment on Gitpod. And if I want to open the QuestDB web interface, it's also available here. And I can just run any query, like for example, tell me how many records I have on this table, or just show me the contents of the table. I don't want to forget, once you finish working with Gitpod, you could just stop the workspace, or you can just delete the whole account, which is what I'm going to do right now. And the third way of doing the demo is doing step by step. Rather than having a single script starting all the infrastructure, I can just start QuestDB and then Grafana by hand. And for that, first thing I'm going to do, let me just copy this line here. So I'm just using Docker here. I'm doing Docker run with the QuestDB image. I'm exposing the ports I need, 9000 for the web interface, 9009 for ILP, the streaming ingestion protocol, 8812 for the Postgres protocol, and 9003 if I wanted to expose monitoring or metrics. So basically, this is going to be an ephemeral container. So when I stop the container, the data will be removed. And just like that, I have an empty QuestDB on the port 9000. So as you can see here, and I am running the latest version. As of today, latest version is 7.3.1. When you are running this demo, it might be a different one, but that's about it. So now you truly want to start ingesting data. And for that, I can go to the ingestion section of the quick start. You can see I can choose Go, Java, or Python. I'm going to be using Python for ingesting, but you could do exactly the same with Java or Go, because we are providing the script in the three languages. When I enter into Python, you can see we have different scripts that you can use. I'm going to be using the one called IoT Simulated Data, because that's the one that is actually displaying data on Grafana. And all I have to do is just install the requirements and start the script. If I wanted, I could change environment variables to point to a different installation, but the defaults are going to be sending to localhost using the default port and user and password, so I'm good to go. All I have to do, it's just, I'm going to actually create a virtual environment, which is a good practice, so I can install my dependencies. I activate the environment. I can now do pip install for the requirements. It takes a little bit, but actually requirements are quite simple. We need basically the QuestDB client library. And now I can already start ingestion. You can see here the logs in my instance. We are ingesting data. If you are curious, you can check the script, but basically this is it. It's a Python script. It's including the ingress, sender ingress error timestamp from the client of QuestDB. It's checking environment variables or using the defaults, and then it's just generating some random data, some sample data, and sending the data row after row using the client. So basically, we are simulating some device data with a type, a duration, latitude, longitude, and some metrics. That's it. And data is flowing now into the system. So now that data is coming here, that, by the way, I could just go to my localhost and select the data. This is the same script that it's executing when you start with Docker Compose or with Gitpod, as we saw earlier in this video. But I have data here, so that's fine. And now, next thing will be displaying the data. So for displaying the data, I can go to the dashboard Grafana section of this quick start. And all I have to do is go to the Grafana directory, start Grafana using Docker, and that's it. And then I will have a user demo with password quest, and I will be able to see my dashboard. Now I have local Grafana up and running. And if I go to localhost 3000, this one here, you can actually get the URL from the Quickstart documentation. But as you can see here, I have a dashboard in which I can see I've been ingesting some data. That's it. I'm ingesting right now 100 records every half a second, and it will do this 10,000 times if I don't stop the script earlier. So that's the data that you are seeing right now here in your Grafana. Something we still didn't do. We didn't load any patch data or run any queries. And for that, we also have a section of the quick start, loading and querying data. And you could do this on top of the local QuestDB we have running now that we started with Docker. But you could do the same if you had started with Docker Compose or with Gitpod. So one way or the other, you can do this part of the tutorial about patch data and querying. So in this page, we tell you, we provide a couple of CSV files. One is with taxi rights information from the city of New York, and the other is with energy data in some countries in Europe. So you can run one, the other, or both parts of the tutorial. For the first one, the trip CSV file, which is provided as part of the repository, what you need to do is just go in to the import part of QuestDB, select the file in your system, and you can just upload without anything else. And just like that, you should see here now, you have also the trip CSV file, and we tell you a few things you could be doing for working with this file, like for example, running this query and exploring the data set, or maybe renaming the table to something different. And the other option you could do, if you want, is just calling QuestDB using the API with curl. So I can just copy this. I can go to the root of the repository and execute this ingestion. And as you can see, I just ingested the second file, the energy 2018 data file into QuestDB. If I come here now, we should see, if I refresh, that I have some energy table, and I could just do select whatever from energy. And yeah, you can see we have some data here, and you could start running your own queries. So that's it. That's the quick start. That's what I wanted to show you. And as you saw on this quick start, there are multiple things we can do. We have started QuestDB, we have started Grafana, we have started a script ingesting data. You could do this either starting the containers individually and then starting the script, or just using Docker Compose or using Gitpod. You're going to get exactly the same results doing any of the methods. Then we've seen how you can ingest CSVs either using the web interface or the RESTful API, and how you query some data. So this gives you a good way of getting familiar with QuestDB, and you can start changing the scripts or the queries or the table to play with QuestDB, learn a bit more, and showcase what's possible. And you know, this quick start repository, it's open source, so your contributions and your pull requests are more than welcome. Enjoy!